Mr. President, today's talking point, the FCC may allow passengers to use cell phones on airplanes. What does that mean? What airlines call the flight experience? First, it is something. Now the Democrats decided to change the rules for information, but their allowance is a long list of nominees to make a job, administrations, and not fit the court.
The sun's trying to fight its way through the clouds.
I think in the long run, both parties are going to be happier, at least that they did this. We are living through, as we talked about before, the highest level of party-line voting ever recorded, going back literally to the very first Congresses. And in that environment, in that kind of quasi-parliamentary system, it is very hard to see how the filibuster survives in its current form, because essentially at some point in a quasi-parliamentary system, the majority has to rule. And I think that the step that happened yesterday was inevitable. I don't think Chris Christie wasn't happy about it, or maybe even Marco Rubio as hard as far as. I think it's better for both sides in the long run if the president can appoint his team. And as all the trends are heading toward just excessive use of this, and even clearly abuse of this process.
They are saying, though, that this could usher in an era of rank partisan warfare. I'm quoting from one of the papers today, beyond even what Americans have seen in the past 5 years.
In this last Congress, I thought just an incredible escalation of the conflict, where Republicans were saying we were filibustering not because we opposed this individual or questioned their credentials, but we simply didn't want the job to be filled at all. We saw that with Richard Cordray, who's now heading the Consumer Finance Protection Bureau. We saw it with these three appellate court judges.